All EV drivers deserve to know their current battery temperature. Hey tech heads, Fina here. So, it doesn't matter whether you have passive or active battery thermal management. I believe that every EV driver deserves to know the current temperature of their battery. Because even if you do have active thermal management, your battery still takes some time to heat up, and arriving at a DC fast charger with a cold battery is one of the most frustrating things, because time is the most valuable thing that we have, and we don't want to waste it. So why do car manufacturers ignore this need of ours? It seems like putting the current average battery temperature into the infotainment system would be pretty easy. Well, until these manufacturers wise up a bit, we'll just have to find other ways to figure that out. Like the one I'm about to show you. Let's go. As you may know, I currently drive a first generation EV, the Volkswagen e-Golf, which has a passively cooled battery, or rather no thermal management at all. Now the Golf does have these Panasonic cells, which were actually really cool at the time it was manufactured. They don't suffer from slowdown during repeated DC charges like the Leaf does, for example. So that's very nice, and in the summer charging is pretty good. But in the winter, it's still a challenge because the battery weighs around 318 kilograms. So I really cannot estimate how much time it's going to take for the battery to heat up before I go charge. So charging was quite a challenge, at least until I found this little hack. So let's take a look inside the car. I want to show you what it's all about. Just going to dig it out here. So my secret hack is this bad boy right here. Okay, so to make charging easier, I started using this OBD2 module along with a Car Scanner app, which I will talk about a little bit later, and I'll leave a link in the description for you. So let's worry about that a little bit later. But for the Bluetooth module, I chose the Konnwei K903. There are many options, but this one had very good reviews, and I found it for a good price, just around 15 euro or so. So that's why I chose this one. So how does it work? So I connect this bad boy into my OBD2 port right down here. Now in the Golf, it's down here on the left side for left-hand drive. I think it's on the right side if you have a right-hand drive, but either way, in your own car, you're gonna have to find out where it is, because as far as I understand, it could be almost anywhere. Anyways, you'll find that information in your manual. But when I connect this along with my app, then I can know the battery temperature, which is, again, really great for me. It shows me battery temperature in real time, so I know when it's heated up enough to go charging, or when it's too cold and I still need to go a little bit driving on the highway. It shows you a lot more information as well, but this is really the most important for me, so that's what I focus on. Okay, I did forget to mention one little thing about this OBD2 module. So this one has one little fly that I'm not a big fan of. If it's not being used for a long time, it goes into standby mode, and then you have to actually press this little button here to get it to connect again. So I put a little piece of Velcro on mine so that I can just kind of feel down here and I can do it even while driving. But it's not the best. So if you do find a different OBD2 module that doesn't have this bug in it that you don't have to keep turning on after it's been turned off for a little bit, then definitely let me know in the comments, because I would love to get rid of this button. Now let's talk about the app and the little cell phone, because by itself, the OBD2 module is not going to do that much good. But if you pair it with an old phone and the Car Scanner app, then you're home safe. So for my phone, I just found this old Samsung S3 Neo at home. The display is perfectly capable of showing me everything that I need to know, so I didn't need to buy a new phone. If you have an old phone at home, you could probably just use that. But now let's take a closer look at the application. So as you can see, the app is called Car Scanner Pro. And again, I am leaving a link in the description so that you can find the right one. There are some other ones with similar names, but you want to use the one that I will leave in the link for you. Now, when I click dashboard here, voila, I have so much information that I'm completely happy with. I have the current state of charge, I have the battery temperature, which as you can see is quite low right now, ambient air temperature, and the BMS current. And what's really nice about this app is that it's very customizable. So you can, I set this screen up in a way that suits my needs, but if you wanted to set yours up differently, you could definitely do that. And I even color coded mine. So as you can see, the battery temperature right now, it's very low. So I have it in blue. When it goes up to 9 degrees or higher, which is perfect for me and my charging needs, it's gonna turn to a green color. My state of charge is the same way. So when it's fully charged, it's a dark green color. Right now, it's sort of a little bit going down, so it's a light green. Once it gets below 50%, it's gonna turn to yellow. And then once it's 25%, it's red, and I need to definitely be at a charger by then. Okay, in case you are interested in some of the other information that the app can show you, you can just slide on over to the next screen. And here I can see, for example, the minimum voltage of the battery cells, maximum voltage of the battery cells. So you can see this one is quite nicely balanced. We have the 12 volt battery. You can see that's charging quite nicely. Temperature, electrical machine, some other information. This is information that I currently don't care about, but if you do, then it is here for your informational needs. This is written in Czech, but this is the highest battery temperature, this is the lowest battery temperature, some other figures here. So again, Car Scanner app, very, very informative. And if you've got an old cell phone at home, you're good to go. Okay, so those are my experiences with my first generation eGolf and the Car Scanner app. Now, I am really looking forward to getting my new EV, which is going to be the Citroen EC4. I should be getting it, I am hoping, next week. So I'm really looking forward to monitoring the temperature there, monitoring the charging speed and all of that. So really looking forward to it. Definitely stay tuned. If you enjoyed the video, enjoyed the hack, then definitely leave a like. You know the drill, subscribe, leave a comment, all of that good stuff. And again, even if you don't have a first generation EV, knowing your battery's temperature, it can be really handy. And this is such an easy little hack that you might as well try it out. I'll see you next time.